Welcome to our month about filing stuff. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, I don't need to file stuff. I have this giant disk drive. And on the disk drive, it's got 2 terabytes of storage. So that means I can keep everything. Even those status meetings from 1892, they could be collector's items someday. Because I'm sure no one else in the world is saving as much stuff as I am. Haha. It's true. You can save tons and tons and tons of stuff. The problem is getting it back when you need it. I mean, Google is trying to condition us to think, all I have to do is search for something. But being able to search for something means you need to remember what's in the something in order to search for it. It also means that whatever is in the something can't be in too many other things, or else you get so many hits that you're stuck. What we're going to do today is clean up those files. And we're going to clean up both the files in your filing cabinet and the files on your hard drive. So, let's start. The secret to good filing is to file things according to how you're going to retrieve them. What that means is you want to think not, what is this thing that I'm filing? You want to think, how am I likely to want to access this thing? So, for example, if you have a bank statement, chances are, if you want to file those because you like to keep your bank statements, at some point you're going to think, wow, I need a bank statement. So filing a bank statement under bank statement makes a lot of sense. But what if you do projects for people? What if you do projects for a client called Shell Oil, and the project is a project where you are surveying an oil refinery? Do you file that under Shell Oil, or do you file that under Survey Oil Refinery? Well, that depends. When are you likely to want to access the file? Well, let's see. I might want to access the file if I'm going to do another survey, which would argue for filing it under survey. But you know what? I might also want to access the file if I'm talking to people from Shell and we're reviewing what have I done for Shell in the past, what kind of projects have we done, then I would want to access it via Shell. So what do I do? What you do is you file it under both. You create one file that's called Shell Oil hyphen surveying for the project, and in that you put a piece of paper and you say, if you need to get to this project, here's where it's filed. And then you would file the actual materials under survey. So if you need to get to a survey, you can do it. Or the other way around. Maybe you file the real file in the folder labeled Shell Oil, and then in the folder labeled survey, you have a little pointer that says, for more information, go see the Shell Oil pointer. Now, if you're doing this in physical files, literally, you want to do it where you actually have a physical file folder, and in it you have a little piece of paper saying, go see the other one. If you're doing it on your computer, you have a file folder labeled Shell Oil, you have another one that's labeled survey, and you can use the make alias or the create shortcut command. All you have to do is take the file or the folder that you want to create, that you want to file in two places, right-click on it, and if you're on a Mac, choose Make Alias. If you're on a Windows machine, choose Create Shortcut. And you will suddenly see a second icon appear, which is an alias to the original file. You put the original file, the place where you want it to go. You drop the alias in a file folder with the other name that you want to file it under. And when you find it on your hard drive, you double-click the alias, and poof, the original file pops open. So this solves the problem of wanting to file one thing in multiple places. You can now do that both on paper, you can also do that on your hard drive. But the other thing is that sometimes we want to group things together. Like, what if you did projects for lots and lots of different companies, and you wanted to survey and say, gee, what kinds of projects have I done in the past? Well, right now you'd have to go through every single thing somewhere in your filing cabinet. Instead, when you want to group files together, and this applies online as well. If you've got 500 files under your My Documents folder, tell you what, it's going to be really tough to find stuff. But if every project, you start with the word project. So the file for the Shell Oil project would be project, survey, blah, blah, blah. The project, if you are creating a movie, and let's say the movie is called Yay, My Heart Beats Loud, it would be project, Yay, My Heart Beats Loud. If you are doing a project that involves revamping your administrative systems for your zombie army, you would say project revamp admin hyphen zombie army. That way, you'll still file these in alphabetical order, or on your hard drive, they'll still be sorted in alphabetical order, but what that means is all of the project files will appear in one block, because they all start with the word project. So it'll be super easy for you to see all of your projects in one place. Now, there's a lot of different ways that you can do this, in a lot of different categories. If you're a marketing manager, for example, you might want to file all of your product launches together in your file system. So you have product launch bouncy balls, product launch free potato chips, product launch action figures, and then all of your product launches will be together in one place in your file folder. Now, as is usual, I don't recommend diving into your file folders and trying to sort them out. What we're going to do is we're going to do this in steps. First, in this first week, all I want you to do is set aside, 45 minutes to an hour. It's not going to take that long. It's going to take you 10 minutes. And just browse through your existing files. And this, do this on your hard drive as well as your physical files. And just make a note of what are the broad groupings. And you'll probably find you've got, 15 or 20 broad groupings, and that's about it. But that's going to be the organizing mechanism that you hang the rest of your sorting on. So for example, if I scan through my file folders, one of the things that I notice is I have a bunch of files that are called presentations, presentation that I gave to this client, presentation that I gave to that client. But I also have a bunch of files that are called workshop, workshop I gave for this client, workshop I gave for that client. What's the difference? There is no difference. Because remember, when am I going to want them? And I'm going to want them if somebody says, hey, do you have anything you can do, any presentation you can give on XYZ topic? So it would make a lot more sense if I had these grouped in one place in my file folder. Again, don't touch your files. Just grab a piece of paper, run through your file system, and note what major groups you're going to want to have. So, another thing is my health insurance. I have filed under the name of the insurance company, but all of my other insurance I have filed under the word insurance followed by the type of insurance. So I have like insurance medical, insurance car, and then I have this one weird one, which is, Allstate insurance, which is nowhere near the rest of my insurance things. Note things like that, because then you'll be able to fold them in and decide where they go. So that's all you need to do in week one, is run through your filing system and decide what are the major groupings that you want your files to be in. And just make a note of those. And I'll give you an advance notice because this is not going to be a big rocket science month. In weeks 2 and 3, we're going to set up a thing where every day you're going to move just a few folders into their ultimate filed place. Now, when I say move folders, another important principle is keeping your online folders and your offline folders in sync. Which means if you have a file called insurance-health, you want to have a folder somewhere on your hard drive also labeled insurance-health. Any electronic things you have, statements that your insurance company mails you electronically, etc., those go in the electronic file, which is the insurance-health file, and either it can be insurance-health or maybe an insurance file and then subfolders, because you can do subfolders online, but you unfortunately can't do subfolders in paper. You'll have your insurance-health anything that's electronic on your hard drive, and anything that's paper, like actual physical receipts you get, statements, etc., filed in your paper file. Because you've given them the same name, it's super easy for you to find everything related to your insurance-health. You just check online in offline in insurance-health, and you check online in your insurance-health folder. And voila, you've now covered both your online and your offline assets. So week one, just browse through your files, spend 15, 20 minutes, and just notice what are the major groupings. While you're at it, any files you don't need to keep, just toss them. Now, don't spend a lot of time. This is not about analyzing what's in all the folders. In fact, you may want to pre-decide. I've even included a worksheet to help you pre-decide. And just make a quick decision as to how you decide what to throw out. Let me give you a hint. If something's more than 7 years old, chances are pretty good you can throw it out with impunity unless it's a legal document that's still in effect. If, really, you still have the problem sets from back when you were in college, like 15 years ago, really? No, those can go. Trust me. And that really important paper that you knew was going to be just the cornerstone of your intellectual life, that article that you cut out and you've been saving all these years,
Bye-bye.
Decide which things you'll throw out. Run through your files, put things into the groupings that make sense, or just note the groupings down on paper. You're not going to start moving files yet. And then throw away any files that you can immediately decide to throw away. In weeks 2 and 3, every day we're going to have you have a little routine and just spend a few minutes, very few, relabeling your folders. And then filing them in the appropriate place. And then, in the last week, we're going to talk about scanning and other ways to combine both your online and your offline systems. So this week is going to be about getting your electronic and your paper files in order, so that instead of spending time hunting for things or searching or wondering where they are, it's really neatly organized so that you can go straight to the information you need when you need it. So remember, A, decide what it is that will be your criteria for deciding when to throw a file away. B, this week, run through your files, throw away any that meet the throwaway, and this is both your offline and your online files. Just toss the stuff that needs to be tossed, and the rest, just note what the major categories are, which files you want to group together. And remember the principle. The principle is you want to group together by how you think you'll reference the files. So when you see a file that's labeled, Bob's Auto, well, is that an auto? Is that a file that you're going to want to reference because Bob's Auto is a vendor and you're going to want to look through and see who are all my vendors? Is that going to be a file that you're going to want to reference because you want to know what the repair history of your car is? In one case, you should file it under vendors hyphen Bob's Auto. In the other case, you might want to file it under car hyphen repair records. So just start taking note of this, because in the second and third week, we're going to have you go through and relabel your folders and your files according to how you reference them, not according to just what they happen to be or whatever random name they have. Go for it. Work less, do more, and have organized files. See you next week.